Good morning everyone, I am Dr. Srikant Appasani, Consultant Gastroenterologist, KIMS Hospital. Today we will be discussing about hepatitis, a common liver problem, and the latest diagnostic techniques and the treatment. Hepatitis means inflammation of the liver. Somebody slaps you, your cheek becomes red, that's known as inflammation. So like that, the liver becomes swollen up because of various reasons, and then we call it hepatitis. So any problem which creates trouble to the liver, wherein there is swelling of the liver and thereby causing problems like pain, some jaundice or appetite problems, will result in hepatitis. Hepatitis sometimes may not show any symptoms except for simple weakness or asthenia, that is inability to do work. Sometimes it does show symptoms. If it shows, it can be in the form of jaundice, a yellowishness of the eyes, yellowishness of the skin, yellowishness of the urine. By and large, it is the other people in your house who will be noticing that your eyes have become yellow or your skin has become yellow, and sometimes you yourself can notice it with the color of the urine. Sometimes, because of the swelling of the liver on the right side, there might be some discomfort or pain which might be dragging on towards the right side. Apart from this, there can be other complaints like fever, and if the liver becomes severely damaged, you can start developing bleeding tendency, vomiting of blood, going into coma, not talking properly, getting swelling of the body and the feet and the tummy, and all those complications which are suggestive of a damaged liver. Now, hepatitis is commonly diagnosed with the help of tests. These tests are of two types. One, the blood tests, which tell how much the damage of the liver has happened. The liver function test, LFT. We look at liver enzymes in the form of SGOT, SGPT and alkaline phosphatase. We also look at bilirubin, which is a very important parameter to check how good the liver is functioning. Apart from that, albumin and globulin levels are also checked. This whole armamentarium is called as liver function test. Apart from this, we check the blood clotting capacity, PT with INR. This is a very important test because the blood clotting parameters are produced in the liver. So when the liver is affected, the blood clotting gets affected, and this report comes in a higher way. Apart from that, we also do the routine tests like blood counts, kidney functions, and the thyroid, etc. Now, the second group of tests are the imaging, that is the scans. We start off with simple ultrasound of the abdomen, the scan of the abdomen, where we look at the liver size, liver texture, and the bile ducts, that is the ducts which carry the bile from the liver into the intestine, and the gallbladder and the surrounding structures. Sometimes we supplement it with a CT scan or an MRI scan when we need finer details. And in this latest era, we also have a special test known as FibroScan, which tells much more details about the liver. Now coming to this FibroScan. It's a scan which tells how hard your liver is. Liver is generally a soft structure. It's very soft. But with recurrent damages happening to the liver, it tends to become hard. So a normal scan does not tell us whether the liver has become hard or not. It can only tell us whether the texture of the liver, that is the surface of the liver, is normal or abnormal, the size of the liver. Whereas this hardness is assessed by a special factor which is known as stiffness. This stiffness is measured by this special scan, which is known as FibroScan. So, as I told you, ultrasound, a scan of the liver, tells you what the liver size is and what texture of the liver is there and whether the surface of the liver is normal or a bit wavy or nodular or irregular. It does not tell us what is the stiffness, how hard the liver has become. Now, FibroScan essentially tells us this factor, that is how hard the liver has become, that is the fibrosis. Apart from this, a scan can tell us that there is fat in the liver. A fatty liver is a very common symptom, which we common finding which we note in many of the scans. Whereas FibroScan gives a CAP score, which tells us the damage it is causing, that the fat causing damage to the liver. So the CAP score is an indirect index of how much fat is there in the liver and how much amount of damage it is causing. So a FibroScan is essentially different from a simple scan in the fact that it tells us how hard the liver has become, how much of fat is there, and how much of damage it is causing to the liver. Now, this hardness in the olden days was diagnosed by taking a small piece of the liver out, which is traditionally known as a liver biopsy. So, liver biopsy essentially is taking a piece out of the liver with the help of a needle and sending it for the testing, which tells us how much amount of fibrosis. Even though it is very good in diagnosing fibrosis, we need to understand that in liver biopsy, we can take only biopsy from one or two areas. Whereas in FibroScan, you can assess the fibrosis in multiple areas because it is non-invasive, you don't poke the liver and it is done from outside. You can take the fibrosis score at different areas, and hence FibroScan is a good tool to assess the fibrosis short of a liver biopsy. So as we discussed, FibroScan detects two essential parameters. One is the hardness, the stiffness, the hard, how much hard the liver has become. Second thing is the fat content, the amount of fat and the amount of damage this fat is containing to the liver in the form of a CAP score. FibroScan tells us two parameters. One is the CAP content, that is the amount of fat and the amount of damage it is causing. Second is the fibrosis content, whether we have mild, moderate or severe fibrosis. So it does tell us whether the liver has got completely damaged and has become a cirrhotic, that is a completely damaged liver where recovery is not feasible, or the damage is still in the earlier stage where we can do some treatment options and consider reversing this process. So FibroScan essentially tells us how hard the liver has become. If it has become completely bad and cirrhotic, that is very hard, then probably it can direct us towards a permanent treatment like liver transplantation. Whereas if it is very mild, probably some treatment options can be considered where this hardness can be reversed. Absolutely not. FibroScan is just like a simple ultrasound where a probe is kept on the tummy and then you take the score out of it. It is not at all painful because nothing goes inside the body except the sound waves. So it is essentially completely risk-free and a painless test. FibroScan is a very rapid test. It hardly takes a couple of minutes to detect what amount of fibrosis is there and to consider a complete report. It probably takes less than 2 minutes to generate a complete report of CAP score with the fibrosis score. Treatment options for liver disease is mainly preventive. We should try to prevent problems happening to the liver. Because once the liver is completely damaged, that is, it goes into cirrhotic stage, there is no treatment option except liver transplantation. So before it goes into completely damaged stage, we should stop the damage happening. That depends upon what is the cause. Suppose if alcohol is the cause, we should stop taking alcohol and prevent the further damage. If hepatitis B and C are noted, then we should take medicines for hepatitis B and C and prevent the further damage. If fat is the cause, that is non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, we call them as metabolic associated steatohepatitis and fatty liver diseases, MASH and MAFLD. So these conditions are there, then we should go to lifestyle changes like weight loss, low fat diet, trying to reduce the weight and the BMIs, and trying to get the fat out of the liver and preventing further damage. So I would like to reiterate the fact that the treatment for most of these liver diseases is preventive. We should try to prevent the damage happening rather than taking some treatment after the complete damage has happened.